dealing with persecution. I'm ass Edomites, you know what I mean? Coming up saying all types of wicked shit. Your own feet, your own family turning against you. You know, you might lose your wife. You might lose your children. You know, you might go to jail. It's all part of the trials of faith, man. And this is how the Lord is refining us. Because the Lord is looking for warriors, man. Boy, hey, look, he already got them. The Lord's elect are warriors, man. You know, soldiers.
Well, I can't salute you on that. I'm the gloves, man. I can't salute you on
that. And they shall, and I will find them as silver as we find. And I will try them as gold is tried. Tried. So the Lord is tried. Like you see, he's being tried, man. He could have been out here for a half an hour and he's talking about his hands cold and leaving, man. You understand? That's the spirit of Satan, man. You understand? That's fucking Satan, man. You know, and I ain't cutting this out. I'm not editing out. You know, he's a devil, man. Satan. You know, here we've been out here for a half an hour. This nigga whining about his hands cold. Need to go home now, man. You know, that's the spirit, right? We're going to the spirit about how the Lord is refining his people, how gold is tried. This fucking devil, I get a benefit of fucking dope. Because what's in the dark always comes to the light, man. I want to say Salakia to the Akium. Go ahead and witness this on camera, man. You know, but it's the spirit of Yahweh shot, man. Not dealing with niggas like that no more. Soft ass, weak ass niggas, man. Bunch of faggot ass niggas. Pussy ass niggas raised by their mother. You know, but it's the spirit of Yahweh shot, man. Not dealing with niggas like that no more. You know, but it's the spirit of Yahweh shot, man. Not dealing with niggas like that no more. You know, but it's the spirit of Yahweh shot, man. Not dealing with niggas like that no more.
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Recha Kodash, and double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. Also a sincere shalom to you elect that's laboring. And I want to touch on a short video, if I can, about the name Yahawasha and how it has bugged out many. And this is proof, okay? Now, before I get started, I just want to say the other brother, one of the heads of the camp, this camp, Taza Warrior, he brought this to my attention, okay? And I said, well, I'll do a video on it about this guy here, okay? This guy, okay, and, you know, it must be said, because normally when people leave, they just leave and they go about their business. But here in Baltimore, man, it has a crazy, crazy spirit, okay, of upstarts. Guys who just wake up and throw in a garment. Okay, anyway, this guy here has ripped pages out of the Bible. And this is no laughing matter. This guy has literally ripped pages out of the Bible and put it in hot boiling water, okay, to make holy water. If you could believe that, okay, through the Lord, all things are possible, even bugging out like that. As many scriptures that goes into men taking more spirits, more demons and more spirits, more wicked than the first. Now, I'll quote a few scriptures going into the law where the scriptures speaks about not suffering a witch to live. That's witchcraft. Okay? No, well, let me just get it, just so I can make sure I'm quoting it. I don't just want to quote it. Haven't read the scripture in a minute, but I'll get it. Exodus 22 and 18. Let me see where it is. Okay, it says, thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. Now, of course, that's his Bible. You had guys even shoot up the Bible. But this guy is literally trying to make up some concoction to creep in some other way. Okay? So he's literally ripped pages out of the Bible. And this is not alleged. This is fact. The brother said he actually witnessed it and seen it. I don't get it. Okay? But then again, I do. This guy's trying to get in the kingdom some other way, thinking it's going to make him extra deep. Okay? When you're ripping pages out of the Bible, throwing it in boiling water to try to expound yourself, to make yourself deeper, there's a problem. And this proves that stick to the milk. A lot of guys is jumping head first in a deep end, and this is what happens. And this may be a part one to this segment. Because there's quite a few groups here with the same, I'm not going to say that same behavior, but have stepped up, woke up, put on garments, and just went out there and said, you know what, the hell with this. I don't care about order. I'm just going to go out and I'm just going to start teaching. You got guys that came to us and then left and went to Adam Abbott and wherever else they want to go. And that's your right, okay? If the Lord sees fit you do that, then that's what you do. But I'm doing this video, really. It's all about edifying and warning the elect of how to come into the truth, younger men who's coming into the truth, how to behave, okay? Just a bunch of wild, wild madness, okay? And that's what this is. Wisdom of Solomon 14:11. Therefore, even upon the idols of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation. Because in the creature of Yahweh, okay, they are the creature of God. Let me say, they are become an abomination, okay? Because they're worshiping, a lot of these guys is worshiping their own gods, man, okay? And the Lord controls both sides, okay? But they're worshiping their own gods. They become an abomination and stumbling blocks to souls of men. And a snare to the feet of the unwise, okay? Everybody always think this is talking about Esau and what Esau does. As I said, the Lord put us in captivity, and we have a responsibility, and I say at Great Millstone, we have a responsibility to get our house in order first, okay? They're going out cursing out Esau, the white man, that they are the devil that the Bible speaks of. But nobody wants to take the time and set their own house in order first. Okay? Let me go on again. It says, therefore, even upon the idols of the Gentiles. Okay, it doesn't necessarily mean that there's some big statue that Jake, even in the truth, claim he's in the truth, is worshiping. But when you try to come in some other way, when you want to try to establish your own righteousness, that's a form of an idol of the Gentiles, man. That's an idol of a heathen custom, okay? Even Esau has some form of order, so how bad are you to just wake up, throw on a garment, and all of a sudden, you're in the truth? And this other guy, Lion of Judah Baltimore, that's to be continued. Nobody know where he's at. He was speaking on being tough, being a soldier of the Lord, stop being pussies, be strong and tough. And nobody seen him. He's went AWOL. From what I understand, he had personal problems, and that does happen. I do, and several people have personal problems, but does that mean take off 2-3 months and pull down all your pages and channels from doing the work? Hey, man. And again, and you know, he hasn't done anything to me. I'm just making a point. That everybody that claims that not all Israel are Israel, okay? Let me go on to Matthew 7:22. Look, man, stick to the milk. If you're a babe in this thing, stick to the milk. Matthew 7:22. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, what's up with these scriptures, man? What's up with these scriptures that we got to read over and over again? What's up with these scriptures? You guys don't want to go through that scripture? Okay, many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? Okay, and that's what these guys have done. They were both out there screaming and prophesying in the name of Yahweh and Yahweh Shah. That's why I wanted to do this video. That name, Yahweh Shah, means he could deliver you to be saved, and he can also deliver you to be destroyed. Okay, that name go both ways, man. You can be destroyed from that name. That name, look, the Yahweh Shah is in the control of that realm. And when you start calling on that name and you're not right, you can get bugged the hell out. Okay? We seen guys call the Lord's name Yoplait Yogurt. These are guys that bug out. And then you got guys that call on the name of the Lord and they ain't right. They even to be seen of men. They even want to have, once this YouTube thing is recognition. Okay, they even wanted to as some social media fad. And this is what we see these guys doing, man. Okay, there's another group I may get on the video, do a video on that they did the work 5 years prior. Okay, maybe 5 years ago, 6 years even. Esau told them they had to move. They never came back. They never put up another video after that. Esau removed them. Really, the Lord did it, but he used Esau to remove them. That means they were doing it for the spirit of men. No garments, not calling on the name of the Lord, but giving double honors to the apostles of great millstone. And you see what the Lord did. And then you know what they did? They hooked up with this guy, these guys, and they blamed us for not letting them come in. You think? You think we would really let these niggas come into our camp through the spirit of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah? You think? I don't think so. Not letting no niggas like that come up in our camp. Okay? Come out, starting out doing their own thing. And then all of a sudden, they want to come up in the camp. Look, if you was doing your own thing from the beginning, then you should have continued to do your own thing. But you know what happens when you can't do your own thing? Then you want to come to us and ask for our oil? I don't think so. This is Matthew 25 and 6. Stick to the milk. That's what I keep saying. Stick to the milk. A lot of you guys haven't even graduated. You're trying to go from first grade to college, man. Okay? Goes on to say, I'll try to read this quick. Matthew 25 and 3. It says, they that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. And that's these guys. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. And that's talking about the elect. And let me say, before I go further, by the Lord's will, the Lord continue me and the brothers in the brotherhood in the faith to continue. Okay? The Lord don't bug me out like that. That's why I'm humbly doing this video. Okay? But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps while the bridegroom tarried. They all slumbered and slept, right? Because they feel the Lord ain't returned yet. That's what it is. Yahweh Shah ain't returned yet. So they just got lazy. Scripture says, woe unto you that lost patience, man. That's the same thing with the year 2000 prophecy. Okay, this would be a good scripture for that. Goes on to say, and at midnight there was a cry made. Behold, the bridegroom cometh. Go ye out to meet him. Okay, then those rose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, give us your oil, for our lamps have gone out. But the wise answered, saying, not so. Not so. So when those guys said, hey, they questioned the line of Judah, Baltimore, and said, look, man, this guy wouldn't let us in our camp. So then you got to ask yourself, when these guys say something like this, well, wait a minute. Well, why the hell they didn't come to us and come in our camp? And I know these guys didn't like us. You know why none of you guys liked us? And there's other guys here in Baltimore the same way. Because you guys don't like order. And you guys hate the apostles, man. You hate Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. You hate order. You hate being under some form of authority. You know why? Because you're a bunch of disgruntled kids, a bunch of disgruntled children that want things your own way. You don't want to do things decently in order, as Apostle Paul said, man. You want to do everything your own way. You don't want to come up under some order. Even if you're out doing your so-called own thing, you don't want the brotherhood. And I know this because I got word to that. I don't trust them. I don't want to be up under them. But then when an elder and apostle come down, here come them little nigglets running to the, try to run like Yahawashah to beam down here himself. All messed up, man, just to be seen of men. But they don't want to come under the brotherhood. You guys are full of shit. Okay? Goes on to say, and the foolish said unto the, and excuse my language to some it may offend. It says, and the foolish said unto the wise, give us your oil, for our lamps have gone out. And that's what happened with these bugged out Negroes, man. So, but some of them are so prideful to try to come and get oil. So they just run off and pull down their channels. Who knows, man? But you know what? A lot of you guys are going to be exposed, man, because it's a lot of wickedness. It ain't just this guy boiling water in them pages. You got guys that are listening to and follow and worship a Khazar, a worship of fucking Khazar. Excuse the language again, but worship, which fuck just means fornication under the consent of the king. Shit is another acronym for ship high in transit, for anybody didn't know. But you got guys that will follow and worship pretty much a Khazar, man. But when it comes to the truth, you don't want no order. You're under a Khazar rat. But when it comes to the truth, you don't want no order. It's a lot of bug outs here, man. And I have no problem exposing none of you guys, man. A lot of you guys are bug outs. And then they could try to trip me up and three-waying me trying to trip me up. Man, you can't trip me up, okay? The Spirit of the Lord is working with us, man. You can't trip me up. I told this guy to leave that other group, man. That I felt that, you know, he was, you know, and I told him I had much love for both of them. But you know what those guys did? They said, hell with you, man. And you know what I'm telling you? You can't have our oil, man. You on your own. Okay? I don't glorify on anybody falling out. Okay? That's not my thing. But I am warning people from guys like this, man. It says, but the wise answer saying, not so. Lest there be enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves. Okay? So at the end of the day, you guys, the problem with a lot of you guys, you never came in right in the first place to even continue down in the path. Okay? Now the Lord keeps who he will. As I said before, by the Lord will, I'm humbly doing this video because I see what can happen. What the Lord can do to you, man. Boiling pages out of the Bible to make holy water to drink means you're trying to come in some other way. You're using witchcraft. Guys that's cursing everybody out, telling them how tough you're supposed to be. And when it tough gets going, you run off. And don't claim family shit. You're supposed to forsake your family for the Lord. That's all I have on that. This might be the first segment. There's more on a lot of these guys, man, that may be exposed. They must be exposed to let you know that when you come up under these groups, and right here you got like, I don't know, about four or five different of these guys in these different camps that's popping up out of nowhere, doing their own thing. Because they don't, and the Lord is showing an example, man. Because these guys, they don't fear the Lord. That's all I have on that. Shalom.